Good morning and welcome to Thinking About the Bible. And today we are back in Colossians 3 and verses 20 and 21. Children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well-pleasing to the Lord. Fathers, do not provoke your children lest they become discouraged. And once again, we find a situation where it's not either or. In other words, you can't say, well, if your parents don't do this, then you don't have to do this. But that's not what it says. It says, children, obey your parents. Of course, there's always the caveat that if parents were telling their children to do something ungodly or something contrary to the Word of God, if they're asking them to do something illegal, for instance, like sell drugs or something, obviously the child, to respect their parents, would be at that point to say, no, I love you and respect you, and I cannot condone that behavior. I cannot confirm you in that sin. So that's a principle that always stands. We don't confirm people in sin. But children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well-pleasing to the Lord. Now, in Ephesians, there's the companion verse in Ephesians 6, verses, I guess I could say, if I can get turned to it here. And these thin pages and the dry fingertips. So, children, obey your parents, Ephesians 6:1, in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth. And then it goes on, and you fathers, do not provoke your children to wrath, but bring them up in the training and admonition of the Lord. A little bit more there in Ephesians, but the point is that children have a responsibility of obedience. It doesn't say at any point that that goes away. Now, we in our modern Western culture say, well, when they become 18, they no longer have to obey, and the Bible doesn't say that. That's a more extensive teaching. I just want to throw that out there for you to think about that. The Bible does not say that there is some magical age of disobedience where you can say, I don't care what you say, I'm going to do whatever I want. The only age in the scripture that is concerns coming to adult accountability is age 20. And we see that in the Old Testament, for instance, when the children of Israel came out of Egypt, and everyone, all the fighting men aged 20 and above, they died in the wilderness because they were held accountable. And it's interesting that those under that were described as those who did not know the right hand from their left, which is as a way of saying they weren't able to make a decision. They weren't able to be held accountable for their decisions, I guess you'd say, at least in that situation. But children, obey your parents. This idea of obedience, and even if we say that, well, at some point they don't have to obey any longer, and I think, just to give you my thoughts on this, I think that at the point that a child enters into the marriage relationship, their duty of obedience to their parents comes to, it's modified. I guess I'll say that much. The duty of respect never goes away. And so a child, what I see a lot of these days is children, they don't obey their parents really at any point, and especially after they reach adulthood. Not only do they disobey, but they see no reason to respect their parents. And that's a sad situation. It doesn't matter if your parents are good or bad. You have a duty to obey them unless they are telling you to do something apart from God's word. And you have the duty to respect them, to not be backstabbing them, I guess you'd say. Because what I do see is children who talk about their parents, talk down about their parents. They show a disrespect and they despise their parents in the way that they speak about them publicly. So that is contrary to God's word. Children, obey your parents, but fathers, don't provoke your children. Fathers need to be loving to their children. They need to be expressing Christ-likeness, just as they do in a different category, but then the same way they do for their wife. They also need to show love and concern and Christ-likeness for their children as well. So either one of these, any of these, would be sermon-length discussion if we were going to actually do justice to this. But in this short format, that's all I'm going to say today. But we will be back tomorrow talking about bond servants and what that might have to do with us as Christians today. I'll see you again.